Здравствуйте, меня зовут Байков Сергей.
Hello, my name is Байков Сергей. I'm TDE's dive technical instructor. I usually use Rebreather in my dives. Diving in closed cycle, you are in complete silence. The Rebreather allows me to dive deeper and with lower amount of gas. The Rebreather allows you to dive longer and with less equipment than open cycle. There are a lot of another advantages. Diving in closed cycle requires the ability to control the breather, understanding the processes in the device and in the environment.
Вокруг, что происходит, какие процессы в ребризере, это влияет на безопасность. Ну и, в общем-то, нужно быть умелым. При этом производители ребризеров,
Мегалодон, Посейдон, Рева. For myself, I choose the company APD Rebreather. Inspiration and Evolution Rebreathers.
Я перечислил достаточно много.
There are devices that can be modernized. You can adopt it to your dives and your tasks, to deep diving or cave diving or recreational diving.
Можно модернизировать, которые можно подстраивать под свои погружения, под свои задачи, будь то технический дайвинг глубоководный, будь то пещерный дайвинг, будь то
рекреационный дайвинг. You can see famous yellow box in front of you. It is plastic. The steel tanks and scrubber fit into it. The drawback of this device is that it's quite fragile. We decided to replace it with a metal frame, which allows you to attach different tanks.
Собственно, позволяет крепить баллоны разной величины. Такой фрейм позволяет закрепить два больших баллона на фрейм, два маленьких стандартных.
This frame allows you to fix two large tanks to the frame and two small standard tanks on the cover of the frame. We have the main body and we have a massive handle. If the rebreather falls, then the hoses will not suffer. There is also a stand that protects the tank valves and regulators. The stand has special ears to attach carabiners for the stage. The first thing is to install tanks. We remove quick release plates. Tanks will be attached with the metal clamps. Now we install the tank. So the diluent tank is ready. We install it to the frame.
Итак, дилуентный баллон готов, и мы его устанавливаем на фрейм.
Now we go to the oxygen tank. The process is the same. We install clamps to the tank and install it on the frame. Now we have a stable construction and we can go to the attachment of the rest of the equipment. To set the wing, you need to open access inside the frame. We unscrew the thumb screw. Remove the cover of the frame. You need to take standard bolts for the single tank configuration. Then we install bolt and wing, upper bolt and lower bolt. In classic version of Inspiration, bracing is provided with various adjustments and front counter lungs. All this structure is bulky, breaks on water, and it is hard to swim in it. I like our configuration with back lungs. They do not interfere. Also, it allows you to fix additional equipment. For the convenience of fixing the lungs, it's better to put the frame. To put on the device, I use conventional monostrop with a metal back plate. We press the wing and contour lungs with the back plate. Then we twist the thumb screw. You see that we have absolute freedom in front of us. Now we install the regulators. Firstly, oxygen. We facilitate many things, so we don't use manifolds in this case. We take the first stage, from it comes a standard long manometer hose. I use such a tablet. Also, there is a short hose blowing counter lung. Another hose is medium long to supply oxygen to the rebreather's head.
очень важный момент. Нужно, чтобы они компактно убирались под разные элементы снаряжения, не торчали и не зацеплялись. Убираем шланг.
Trace of hoses in the rebreather is a very important point. They need to be compact. They don't stick out and don't catch on. We remove the screw by the back plate. Now it doesn't interfere. The manometer hose runs along the belt. It goes to the D-ring to attach the stages and goes to the lower D-ring. When I need to see it, I take it out, check and remove it back. On the D-ring regulator, there are standard manometer hoses. One goes to the IDV inflator and another goes to the wing inflator.
Теперь устанавливаем шланг под доуди лента. Таким образом он у нас находится всегда на плече на кольце и не болтается. Теперь мы устанавливаем канистру скрубера.
Now we install the screwbar canister. Twist the connection of the right lung. Then we install the most expensive part of the rebreather. This is a head. Then we connect the oxygen blowing hose. There is a special window in the frame, and we connect the inhale lung.
И подсоединяем непосредственно легкое вдоха. Как я уже говорил, фрейм продуман до мелочей. И как вы видите, какие-либо ненужные пустоты здесь отсутствуют.
Now you can see a small element. We are installing the cover. It protects the structure and makes it more durable. On the cover, there is a weight pocket in which you can put 2 or 3 kilograms of weights.
И крепим эту крышку болтом. Если вы обратили внимание, на крышке впереди установлен карман, в который можно уложить 2 или 3 килограмма груза. И теперь вы видите, насколько компактно выглядит ребризер впереди. У нас есть для крепления стейджей. С левой стороны у нас дилуэнтный поддув. С левой стороны чуть повыше крыло. Никакой из этих элементов не свисает ниже груди, когда мы плаваем.
Если нам нужен правой. If it is difficult for someone to reach it with the right hand, then you can move it the inflator to the right
D-ring.
Now you see how different these two designs are. In the standard version, the lungs are located in front. There is also an inconvenient inflator. When we dive, everything hangs invertibly. It's hard for us to reach the rings on which the stages are attached. We don't see the manometer, and it hangs out
inventively.
So I showed you our version of a rebreather adaptation and how various equipment can be attached to it. I think it's a very good decision. And if you ever try to dive in this configuration, definitely you will appreciate it.